In this video, we'll look at how you can use AI to write and generate text. You can use this to respond to emails, write cover letters, change the tone of your messages, and so much more. Basically, you'll be able to communicate better and also faster. And best of all, it's completely free to get started, although there is also a paid plan that gives more functionality. Let's check this out. Head to the following website. You could click on the card in the top right-hand corner, and I've also included a link down in the description. This drops us on the Grammarly homepage, and you might have heard of Grammarly before. They're known as a writing assistant that will check for various types of errors, like spelling, grammar, punctuation, clarity, and engagement. But now, it's also AI-powered. Now, you might be thinking, sure, there are lots of AI writing apps out there, so why would you use Grammarly? Well, first off, the reality is that you're probably working in multiple apps every single day, whether it's Microsoft Word, Slack, Google Docs, and that's where Grammarly comes in. They work where you work, so you can always have high-quality communications. Second, you also get recommendations as you type. That way, you can improve your writing directly in line. And third, Grammarly's AI model is specifically tuned and designed to improve the quality of your writing compared to general purpose AI models. On the website, click on the button that says sign up. It's free. Once you finish installing Grammarly, you'll see this overlay icon anywhere you go to write. And that could be in any app or on any website. So let's say Google Docs, Microsoft Word, Outlook, Gmail, Slack, or even let's say on Facebook. Here I am in Microsoft Outlook, and I would like to apply for a job. And I've always heard that writing a cover letter is a good idea. So let's see if Grammarly can help me with that. Over on the right-hand side, I'll click on this icon on the overlay. And this opens up the AI assistant. Right up on top, I have a few ideas of how I can get started. And down below, we have this text field. Here, I can specifically prompt the AI. So let's test this out. I'll type in a little bit of information about myself. I work as the chief baker at the Kevin Cookie Company, been there 12 years, I've been promoted, and I've won some awards. Yes, best cookie baker is a thing. Can you write a cover letter for me? There's my prompt. With the prompt, the more descriptive that you can be, the better your response will look. Over here, let's send this prompt to the AI. And look at that! Grammarly has now generated a sample cover letter that I can use. And that did it way faster than I could ever do it. Now, if I go up to the very top, here I see my original prompt. And here I see the message. Of course, I probably want to go in here and customize or tweak the message. For example, instead of saying, "Dear hiring manager," perhaps I could fill in the hiring manager's name. Now, one of the neat things is when you look at this message, it takes the information that I provided in the prompt and it incorporates it into the cover letter, and then it also expands upon it. Here I see it call out that I have 12 years of experience at the Kevin Cookie Company. It also calls out that I won multiple awards. It also calls out that best cookie baker of 2022. It's very important to read through the entire message though, just to make sure that everything is accurate and that it's representing the truth. For example, here it says, "I am skilled in managing a team of bakers." I didn't provide that information in the original prompt, but it probably assumed it based on my time at the company. But let's say I wasn't a manager, I'd probably want to go through and remove that from this cover letter. So again, it's very important to look through it just to make sure everything is accurate. Down here at the bottom, it says, "Sincerely, your name." Here too, I'd probably want to fill in my name. Overall, I think this is a really good place to start, and it'll save me so much time at pulling together a really effective cover letter. Down here, let's click on insert, and this now inserts the message directly into my email. Right up on top, I could click on the X icon, and that closes out of Grammarly. Grammarly continues to work in the background to make sure that my communication is very high quality. Right down below, I see various underlines. Over in the overlay, I see this counter with 7 suggestions. When I click on that, I can go through and review the various suggestions. Here, it's recommending that I rewrite this sentence for clarity. Originally, it said, "I look forward to the opportunity to meet with you and discuss." Instead, it recommends meeting with you and discussing. I think that's clearer, so let's click on rewrite for clarity, and that now replaces that sentence. As a note, rewriting is a premium feature. Over here, I can also adjust the tone of the various sentences, and here it says that it'll improve connections. I can move this toggle over to the left, and I can see the existing sentence or the current tone. I look forward to meeting with you and discussing my qualifications. That's okay, but here, this will make it more personable. I'm looking forward to meeting with you and talking about my qualifications in more detail. I think that does sound more personable. So over here, let's click on rephrase, and let's incorporate that change. Just like with rewriting, tone suggestions are also a premium feature. Over here, I'll click on the X icon. Over on the left-hand side, you might have noticed that some of these sentences have green underlines. This is a new Grammarly premium feature. As you're typing, Grammarly's AI proactively evaluates your writing to make sure that you're including the necessary details and that you're also focusing on what's crucial. So let's take a look at one of these recommendations. Here in my first sentence is, I'm excited to apply for the position of head baker. So when I hover over this, here I could see the recommendation. It says, highlight your passion for baking to make the hiring manager feel your enthusiasm and dedication. And right down below, I can click on show this change to see how I can make that true. Right here, it says, I am thrilled. Here it says, passionately crafted. Now I am eagerly seeking new challenges. By including all those different words in these sentences, that definitely shows a lot more enthusiasm. And I think that's a really good contribution there. Down below, I can click on accept, and that'll automatically modify the sentence to include those recommendations. And I think that really makes this sentence a lot stronger. Along with reviewing all of the AI suggestions, I can also direct the AI to improve or rewrite my text. I'll press Control A on my keyboard to select all of my text. Then, over on the right-hand side, let's go to the overlay and click on this icon. Over here, we can improve the text, we can shorten it, and I also have more options. I'll click on More. And if we scroll down a little bit, we see all sorts of different options to rewrite this text. For example, maybe I want to make it more descriptive, or maybe a little more detailed. Here, we could even simplify it. And again, lots of different options to rewrite. If I scroll down a little bit more, here we also have options to adjust the tone of the text. For example, we can make it sound more assertive, or maybe compassionate, or here, confident. And again, lots of different options. Overall, I'm feeling pretty good about the existing cover letter, so I don't think I need to make any of these changes, but it's good to know that they're here. This is especially useful if, say, you compose a message and you would like to make some changes to your tone. You have that option. I'll close out of this view. At the very bottom of my cover letter, I should probably include a link to my resume. So right down here at the bottom, here, let's add a line and I'll type in, you'll find my resume here. Now, one of the nice things about Grammarly is it connects to all sorts of different third-party apps like Google Drive or OneDrive or Confluence. Right over here, I'll click on this Grammarly overlay and let's click on this icon. And then let's click on more. And here you'll see all the different apps that you can connect to using Grammarly. And right up here, I can find a file in Google Drive. This is where I have my resume stored. I'll click on this, and right now I can see all of my recent files. Right at the top, I have my Kevin Stratvert resume. And when I click on that, that inserts a link directly to my file. Now, one of the beautiful things there is I didn't have to leave my email message to get this link. By using Grammarly, I'm able to access all of my recent files directly in line. I'd like to make it really easy for the hiring manager to find time to meet with me. I'll insert a new line and let me type in the text, feel free to schedule time with me to chat. But I'm not just going to leave it at that. I actually want to make it easy to schedule time with me. So let's go back over to this overlay, click on this icon, and then click on more. And here again, we see all those different apps that Grammarly connects to. And to get this full list of all of these different apps, you need a premium Grammarly subscription. The free version of Grammarly only includes Giphy and also Unsplash. Again, you have all sorts of different options, like here's Asana, Monday.com, Rike, HubSpot, just to name a few. Now, right at the very top, I have the option to share availability via Calendly. Let me click on that. And over here, I can set up the length of the event. I think a 30-minute meeting will do. And here I could type in text. I'll simply leave it at here and then click on insert. And here, this now inserts my text into the email message. So there I could say, feel free to schedule time with me to chat here. Now the manager can click on that and then they could set up time to chat with me. I'm making it really easy for the hiring manager. Before I send this message out, I want to verify that my resume actually looks just as good as this cover letter looks. So right up on top, I'll click on this link to go to my resume. This now opens up my resume directly in Google Docs. And to be fair, this will probably take a little bit of work before I'm ready to send this out to the hiring manager. But one of the nice things is here too, I also get that Grammarly overlay directly in my web browser. So this way I get all those same recommendations and also suggestions wherever I happen to be working. In the past, I probably would have asked coworkers or maybe family to review all of my different communications, but now I could simply rely on Grammarly. Grammarly makes writing so much better and also faster. Once you start using it, you'll begin to realize how much you rely on it as part of your daily communications. The great thing is that it's free to start using and you get 100 AI prompts every single month, which will cover you for much of your writing. With a premium plan, you get 1,000 AI credits, all the app actions, the inline AI suggestions, and a lot more. If you write a lot, it's well worth considering. To watch more videos like this one, please consider subscribing, and I'll see you in the next video.